In this lecture, we will look at the heal tool. The clone and heal tool differ in one essential way. The heal tool doesn't transfer hue and saturation, but only value. I have opened red-green. The red and green surfaces differ in that the green has variations in darker and lighter green pixels, so it has value changes, and the red does not have this value variation. Now let's compare the clone and the heal tool. I start with the clone tool by pressing S and select the brush with 90% hardness. I set the size to about 200. I take a sample from the green by control clicking on it, and I click once at the left in the red area. As we see, we made a pure clone, value included. Now I select the heal tool. Again, I sample the green area by control clicking on it, and I click at the left in the red area. As we can see, the heal tool does not copy the color, so it doesn't copy the green. All that is transferred is value. This means only the structure of the green is brought over. This is very valuable for retouching, as we will see. If I go the other way around, from red to green, we see the structure in the green is removed, because there isn't any structure in the red. Let's look at a practical example. I have opened Girl Close Up. I zoom in to 400%. I want to remove this brown spot. I will use the clone tool first. I set the size to 20 and choose a hard brush. I sample by control clicking and clone. We can see the colors don't match, so I don't want to clone color. Now let's do the same with the heal tool. I press Ctrl Z and press J to select the heal tool. I sample again by control clicking and click on the spot. I press Ctrl 1 to go to 100%. I open the history panel and use the up and down arrow keys to see the before and after. As we can see, the heal tool works well in situations with different colors. I will also remove the spot at her chin. I make the brush a bit bigger to about 40. I sample by control clicking and paint the blemish away. In this lecture, we have seen what the heal tool can do. In the next lecture, we will go a step further and look at a professional skin retouching technique called frequency separation.